From them were the people that are all going to originate from Jazeera al-Arab towards the east. Yani, if you look at the Ariba, they're all going to be originally from Yemen. Yemen was the heartland. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He make the affairs of Yemen easy today and bring peace and tranquility back to Yemen. This was where the Arab began. Now, if anybody is from the land of Sham, or Morocco, or Egypt, or Northern Africa, or if you go into most of what we're considered Arab in the land of Iraq today, unless they are from the Bedouin tribes, unless you can trace it back, like in Jordan, for example, they have tribes that you can trace back to the original Yani Musta'arab Arab, or in Iraq as well. But most of those are not actual Arabs. I mean, they are Arab, but not DNA-wise, right? So this is interesting to understand. What do you consider to be a part of a particular race? Like, what factors do you consider? Different races have different ideas. For example, mostly in the West, we look at DNA. Like, if somebody is if you do a DNA test and they turn out to be, you know, whatever percentage from a certain DNA family, then they consider you to be part of that race. But that's not always the case, right? If you were to take that definition, again, I apologize if anybody needs to drink some water or sit down, go ahead. If you take that definition of a DNA test, then the vast majority of who consider themselves Arab today are not Arab. Like in Egypt, most are Coptic, ethnically, not religiously, ethnically. And they had their own language until Islam went to Egypt and Islam spread and Arabic spread. North Africa, hardly any of them are going to be actual ethnic Qaba'il Arab. Arab are all Qaba'il, Arab are all tribes. Like, there are different types of people in the world. Some people are tribal, some people are non-tribal. North Africa has had their own. The Arab, they were the ones that went to North Africa, but most of them that speak Arabic today were either Berber, which is Amazigh, yani, or other people, other Aqwam that were there, and they picked up Arabic, and some of them call themselves Arab today, some of them still call themselves Amazigh, but they speak Arabic. The same is true for most of North Africa. You see a lot of people very proud of being Arab, and you're like, just letting you know, bro. And if you look at Sham, for example, right? If you look at Sham, and again, there are those that may be from Arab tribes, but the majority of them, if you did a DNA test, they would not come out to be Arab. They don't come out to be Europeans, a lot of them. I mean, don't forget that the Roman Empire was pretty much centered around that area for a long time, and the trade and all of that, and you will find all kinds of different types of people. Now, races are different. This definition of a DNA test is a certain type of a definition. For example, Yahudis, Jews, they have a different definition of what it means to be Jewish. They say that you have to go by the mother, not the father, the mother. Now, most people, their lineage in most cultures, it goes by the father. If your father is a certain race, you're considered that race. But in the Yahud, it goes by the mother. And we had a gentleman come and discuss with us at the tables at Balboa Park recently. Unfortunately, the audio wasn't on, so we don't have a recording, but many of you were there. He was a Orthodox-ish Jew. And he explained, may Allah guide him, and he was very polite, and he explained that. And I asked him, why is that? I asked him, why is it that in the Yahudi race, you go by the mother? He said, well, we're not always sure who the father is, right? That's not my answer. That's what he said. Brothers were there. Can I get a witness? So, I told him, alhamdulillah, in our nations, we're always sure who the father is, alhamdulillah. But if you guys aren't, I understand. And if it's that big of a problem that you got to change your genetic understanding of a race, interesting.